Hello again, fellow Spark drivers. Hope you're doing well, staying safe out there, making that chili cheese. I'm going to talk a little louder because I got some rain all around me, as you can see. Good old summer rain. Better than snow, though. But I'm glad to see the incentive programs are back. $36 for 12 trips, not a lot of money. That's kind of what we get offered with the batch orders. But it is something. And gas here, it's up to, you know, $4.68, $4.67. And I know it's higher other places. We're all going through this. But anything that helps, you know, is good. And hopefully you don't break even on days and such, where you spend like, you know, $70 on gas and you made $100. And so I'm hoping they up the pay on the bonus programs and just pay in general. Make it worth our while. You know, because you got orders coming in every hour, every day, and you want to keep up with demand, grow, be profitable, throw more money our way. Speaking of money, no update with the daily pay, unfortunately. I've been checking those two sites and both the articles are still gone, but no daily pay. What's the holdup? And, but believe me, I'll keep you informed, because once that hits, I'll make a video, and it could be like 2 seconds, me just being like, daily pay, get your account activated. So I'm imagining something fell through with Branch, or there's just been a delay, but the no communication thing is, I mean, that's just bad business. Communication is so easy. Just send out an email, let us know what's going on. But anyways, let's get into it and talk about deactivation. I already have a series about this, but I wanted to go more in depth because several of you have reached out to me on social media, and I want to give you my advice, what I would do if I'm deactivated. So let's get right into it. So I've actually recorded this a few times, a few different takes, but ultimately I couldn't give like really solid advice, like a step-by-step. So what I'll do is try and help you, because this is what I would do. I would treat it like a legal case. I'm not saying threaten legal action. I'm not a lawyer. I don't know about that stuff. But have your side of the story ready. And if you're unsure of details, dates, what happened and such, I would reach out to the store, Walmart, talk to the store manager, find out if it was an associate or a customer who reported you and why. So you can jot that down in your notes and have your side of the story ready. Because if you know, you're like, oh, I know which incident they're talking about or something, just have your side, because they should hear both sides of the story or context and such. And then I would reach out to Spark DDI support. I'll have an email address for you in the description, because I referred somebody to that. And, you know, problem is, like, if you don't even remember and you're not really at fault, let's say, it's like, when did I curse someone out, or when did I do this or that? Best thing you can do is plead your case, and also ask the store manager if the associate and or customer could, you know, write out a transcript of what they felt happened, what went wrong, what was wrong to them, and they can share that with you, because that's important. And basically, maybe make a video about it, maybe post on Reddit and get feedback. Instead of like hiring on a legal team or a lawyer, you can just reach out to the public and be like, this is my case. And if you did mess up on something, you own up to it. And let's say it's your first strike and you show your metrics and such. And, you know, if it's your third strike, I can understand. But if this is like a first time occurrence and you're not even sure, like, what did I do wrong? Basically, I would throw it out on social media so you can get feedback, and people who have been through this before can share their story, and maybe some of them got reactivated. And it'd be unfortunate if it came down to legal action. But I've heard from some people, like, they refuse to give me details on this and that. And it's like, really? Because independent contractors, we should get a lot of data, a lot of statistics every month. The metrics, what we see, we don't see comments from customers or associates. I'd like to know what people think, you know? And these days, you know, we drop off orders, we don't have actual contact with the customer. But still, how was their experience? We should see those notes. And for those of you watching who are thinking about being a Spark driver, or you're a customer, you get groceries dropped off, know that we don't get those details. We don't get that data. And it's not that we own our own business per se, but we need those details, especially in issues like these. So you have your side of the story, throw it on social media, see what happens. And if you just don't get any really solid feedback, advice as to what to do, which I highly doubt, I would reach out to a legal firm or something, maybe email somebody, just say, this is my case, this is what happened. Do you want to be reactivated, or you just want this justified? You've already moved on to another job, let's say. But it may come down to that. But again, like, don't spend a bunch of money. Just kind of get your story out there in that. And that's the best advice I can give. Unfortunately, there's no way to dispute this when it happens. Like on YouTube, you have your three strikes, and you can dispute claims, copyright claims and such. And I like that. Not like somebody reports like, oh, you used my song, and then your account is shut down. Because that's what this is. And I hate to compare it to this, but cancel culture, essentially. Like one customer says like, oh, well, you know, the bags, the way they were laid out, or I think something was missing, or this person, they just threw the bags down. And it's like, yeah, but what's the other side of the story? Why is it you get reported and you get deactivated? But details. Again, was this your third strike? How are your metrics and such? But just have your side of the story ready. And hopefully in the future, because of all the deactivations, all the people they cycle through with this app, they'll be like, we should have a more of a legal system in place. So you can dispute claims, you can give your side of the story. And because I don't know, I mean, there are a lot of people in the world, but the rate they're going through drivers and the reviews on the app, I would change things up. And, you know, we all mess up, we all make mistakes in that, but sometimes you're not even aware of like, wait, what did I do wrong? Like, did the customer leave notes about, you know, specifics and such? Because if you want your bags laid out in a certain spot in a certain way, it's like, we don't just know that. And the notes, they can only input so much information. So I hope this helps. I've recorded this a few times. I recorded a full video a few weeks ago, but it just kind of went nowhere. But if any of you have experienced this and you were able to get reactivated, please share your story, your advice down below, and correct me on anything. Because again, I'm not saying threaten legal action. I'm just saying treat it like a court case. Just have everything ready and then blast it on social media. But also don't blast, don't put down Spark or DDI or anything, because, you know, they're just doing their job in that. So they're told, like, if this person gets reported, deactivate them. But maybe not even mention the company. Just say, hey, I was deactivated and I was an independent contractor doing deliveries and such. And because if you shame them on social media and such, then that could result in them suing you or something, you never know. But, and if you find out if it was an associate who reported you or a customer, and let's say they tell you the name, like, don't confront the person, I would not do that. And you just get their side of the story. If they can write out a transcript or record themselves, if they're willing to fight it in court. But, okay. So I think that's going to do it. And watch the deactivation series tips on... Basically, I've been with Spark for just over a year. So I'll just give you advice on, like, you know, this is how I've kept my metrics high. And don't do this, don't do that. But none of this is telling you what to do. And I really hope this video helps, because I know it's frustrating and I'm worried one report and I'll be deactivated and I won't even get any details and have to spend a bunch of money, which I don't have, on a legal team or a lawyer. But just know, even if you know the incident and you're like, you know that you messed up, let's say, for whatever reason, you should still be able to drive. It's nothing extreme. If it was like physical assault, I could understand. the deactivation. But it was something, there was like a miscommunication, like, oh no, I wasn't talking to you at that time. I was on the phone with somebody, something like that. And, or if you did legitimately mess up, it happens. And you shouldn't be fired over that, because... But, yeah, let me know in the comments below, again, if you've experienced this, and what advice you have for others. Please leave comments on that. And I appreciate those of you who have reached out to me about this, and I've tried my best to, you know, reply to that. But, thank you very much for watching. And, like this video up, subscribe for more. I will see you next time. Keep on sparking.